Hey, Renee.
Hello, world. I'm Dennis, and this is Renee.
Hello. Hello, Renee. I'm Dennis. And listen, thank you for asking me on tonight, but this is supposed to be Rory's show. Where the hell is he?
I don't know, but I think I have some answers. I'm going to play a video if you want to watch a video. I think I have some answers. Let's just see.
There he is.
There he is, but I don't know if he's actually here. He's not live. Look at this.
Hey, this is Rory Pillen, and I'm still working.
Still working.
As Dennis Tardan is our main guest for tonight, I'm hoping that he will interview some of our regulars on the show, whom we have reached out to and said, hey, would you like to be interviewed for a few minutes for the show? So happy holidays, and hopefully I'll see you in about 30 minutes.
Oh, okay. All right. Well, that answers that.
Okay. Well, yes, that's fine. But now what do we do?
Well,
this is my
know.
First time hosting the show, Renee. So maybe you could you're here every week. So perhaps you could guide me into what we're doing here tonight.
If only we had a background in broadcasting. Well, what we're doing tonight is that I was so proud, and I was waiting for this very night to unveil this peacock feather. And then I was hurrying, and then I clamped down my headset on it, and now it's all fecocked. You see that? But I want to get credit for doing the peacock, and then I have this thing here.
And what is that thing?
I don't know. It's 1920s. You know, it's supposed to be very chic, but it's like too big. I got the smallest size, but it looks too big. I don't know. It's just, it's fecocked.
Oh, okay, so you're flapping tonight.
Thank you. I'm supposed to be flapping tonight, but it's not really that good. Wait till you see Kim. Wait till everyone sees what Kim's dressed like. She's going to blow this out of the water. Wait till
we don't seem to be doing very much Christmassy. So I would love to see if Kim can help us with this Christmas spirit then, since Rory's not going to be here.
So let's add Kim Ware. Of course, she's the co-founder of Kimono My House. She's a musician.
Hello,
Kim. We love her.
Hello, guys.
It looks like you're all decorated up. Is Christmas a big deal for in your family?
Not at all. That's what's cracking me up is that I look like this compared to you guys.
You look so festive.
Oh yeah, exactly. You look like you wait every single year about December the 1st and then begin pulling out things and decorating, getting all the tinsel and that's what you look like, but again, this is your acting ability. So you could certainly play it beautifully.
Okay. I'm sorry, let's rewind and I'll say yes. Yeah. I have been waiting all year for this day.
Let's just play the part and talk about the Christmas cactus. Our producer, Jonathan, said, talk about the Christmas cactus.
Oh, yeah, the Christmas cactus. My husband and I got that cactus probably a good, 8 or 10 years ago at IKEA in Atlanta. This is not a plug for IKEA, but they have some cool cacti from time to time. And it was just a wee little thing. It was like half that size. And now it's like, instead of a Christmas tree, we like to do the Christmas cactus.
Okay. Well, all right. That's wonderful. I mean, it's prickly, but it's there. I mean, it's certainly nothing that you want to approach with small children to go, oh, look,
I feel like you just described me. I'm prickly, but I'm there, and it's nothing you'd want to approach. We have a guest, Dennis, because I
What's
know
that?
Rory's not here, but we do have a guest. Yes. Would you like to bring him up?
Oh, well, please. I mean,
he's a crowd favorite. Look who he is.
Hey, how's everybody doing?
Hello.
Oh, my gosh.
Hello. Happy holidays, everyone.
Happy holidays.
Oh, it's holiday guest Cam is
exactly
the holiday guest.
Well, congratulations. The guests are going to be sitting, I guess.
Well done. I mean, it's the warble, I think, that really makes it. That makes it when you can bring that to the scale. Do you warble all the time?
Oh,
that's
no,
what I thought. All right.
Going.
So now, this is amazing. I did not know that he could do that. I did not know that he could do that. I don't know how you do that with your voice. They're able to make that gargling sound, but it's an extraordinary talent. I'm very impressed.
Earlier.
Warble, yeah. Yes, we're having some. The audio is a little wonky.
No, a little wonky would be low or high. This is on beyond wonky. This
okay,
is
let me,
way
I'm in the
deep
green room.
into the chocolate factory. There's
just
no
rebooted.
Question.
Let's see what happens. Okay, say something, Elvis.
Something, Elvis.
And it's only getting worse. This is great. This is absolutely fabulous.
Dragon Elvis sounded great beforehand, but I don't know what happened. But you might have to reboot because it's all like a robot,
satanic robot.
Yeah, a satanic robot. Yeah, a satanic robot with his balls in a vice.
Okay, can we not get to
that?
Exactly. That's exactly that is exactly what
satanic Elvis robot
in the middle of a snowstorm being run over by a Mack truck.
This is the comment. All dragon, no Elvis.
Oh, dragon.
Oh man.
All right. Well, you better reboot and come back and see us, Elvis.
Yes, please come back. Please, Elvis. I'm begging you, please. Although I'll never get that balls in a vice thing out of my head. I think now every Christmas I'm going to have that in my mind. Thank you, Dennis.
Right. You know the difference between snowmen and snow women?
Oh my gosh.
Snowballs.
Okay. Are we going to have to be?
Please don't step on my line. I
stepped on his line. No, we're going to do it again. We're going to do it again. Say it again. I'll be good.
Okay. And by the way, this is the lovely thing about having a producer and a partner like Renee Jaworski. And I promise you, anybody around it, because you can tell her a joke twice and she allows and she'll think it's wonderful even the second time. And Renee will nod as if she's hearing it the very first.
I'm preparing for early dementia. I think I'm just preparing for early dementia. I'm equally enchanted. I'm enchanted 56 times in a row. I'm like, that's hilarious. Okay, let's do it. What's the difference between? We'll switch it. I'll just steal it. You know, I'll do like a Robin Williams.
Why don't you do it? Go ahead.
You know the difference between snowmen and snow women?
What is?
Snowballs. We need you to have your drum set.
Sorry.
Amity says we're looking fab. Thank you. Yes. And of course, Kim, did you get to tell the nice people about your wonderful holiday sweater?
Well, this is my mother's sweater.
Hello, this is Linda. Did Linda design it? Did she make it or did she gift it to you?
No, she acquired it from a friend probably, or I mean, maybe purchased it back in the day. It's really old. She said, I'm trying to get her to join Kimono so she can watch this. And she said, every time. It's like reteaching her how to do all this. And she said, I told her to go how to find the group. And she said, I did that and got your stuff. So I don't know what that means. I don't know if that means that she's here.
She's seeing all of your old shows. She's sitting scrolling for it. So however long it takes for her to get to the end of that, and then you'll get your mother back.
Maybe. Yeah, I don't know.
And
but
maybe, or she might be lost down the rabbit hole.
She might be. We have another guest. Let's see if the robot has been fixed. Let's see.
Oh, yes.
Jelly cake.
Hey, Jelly cake.
I swear he's doing this on purpose. However, I swear, because in a sound check, this did not happen.
No,
what?
This is when Jelly cake.
Oh, no.
Hope y'all doing good.
We're doing good, Jelly Cake.
Thank you.
I'm laughing too hard. I'm crying. Kim, I'm crying. I can't. I love live television. I just want to go on the record. I say this every time we have a glitch, but for me, this is what I get off on. This is my adrenaline rush, and I know everyone else hates it, but good God, I love it. I love you so much, Jelly Cake, for this. Thank you.
Thank you for coming
in. Oh, no, man.
Kim and I are about to pee our pants.
You guys are great.
Y'all are going to get to bed.
There you go. That's just fine. I can't understand a word, but the good news is that even when you're sane and sober and your audio is good, I have a hard time understanding you, but that's okay. That's okay. That's just me and my old ears and my, you know, and so that's what we're trying to do.
What does Jonathan think about it? Jonathan, do you hear the audio?
I do hear the audio, and if you see my head explode like a cherry, you will know why.
Yeah.
Jonathan does not appreciate the wild, wonderful world of live television.
Yeah, because I don't thrive in chaos like you do.
All right, I'm putting you in the green room. I'm banishing you. I have a feather. I have a peacock feather tonight, y'all. I'm just telling you, I'm wielding this feather. I got power. There he goes. There you go. Now, Jellycake, what's your response, Jellycake?
What do I want?
Oh,
I'm good, man.
Kim and I cannot handle this level of beauty. We cannot. Jellycake, we got to put you in the green room. Please try to reboot. Please, if you have to change phones or something, okay. Lord.
Check your connector.
All right, well, it's very all nice, right. Very, very nice being
my favorite that. Thing is that Dennis, here's the thing, Dennis has been in broadcasting for like 45 years, and so for him, he just rolls with it, and he's like, all right, and he's got that gravitas in his voice, he's like,
isn't move on to the next thing, well, you move right, on to Joey, the next segment.
Dennis, you're losing our shit, and Dennis is like, well, all right, Dennis.
Dennis, guys, that's just fine. It reminded me of the dog, you know, the dog, the meme with the dog, and everything's on fire.
Yeah,
and everything's on fire, and Dennis is like, "This is fine." He's like, "This is fine.
That's just fine.
Don't worry about it." How you doing? I'm over here with the really cool guy here. So he's the
President,
one that keeps me. He's the one yes. that keeps me cool.
Okay.
Do you see the solemnity on his shoulders? That's the burden. The weight of the world is there. Okay. Well, Kim, I don't know. What if Kim plays us a song?
Would you please, Kim? Would you play us some?
I think that'd be a nice transition.
I'll do that. Yeah.
Yeah. That'll help. That'll help everything settle down. That'll help all okay. the technology and everything. You're so soothing, Kim, and you certainly do that every time that I'm around you.
Thank you. So it's funny because I love this holiday, as I said.
You obsess mm-hmm. over oh, yes, every absolutely. Year, Kim. We can't pull you away from Christmas. You just sit around yeah. waiting, looking at the calendar every day.
Yeah, except for sometimes I don't. And this
keep,
year,
keep the falsehood alive.
I know. Okay.
Improv.
So you're going to be like, well, then why did you pick this to put? So this is an Everly Brothers song, actually.
Oh, I love Everly Brothers.
Dude, me too. The winter's flaking snow is brushing through the wiry tree. I stuffed my hands down inside my coat. I think of years ago and half-remembered Christmas trees and faces that still warm me with their glow. The cold and empty evening hangs around me like a ghost. I listen to my footsteps in the snow. The sound of one man walking through the snow can break your heart, but stopping doesn't help, so on I'll go. And Christmas Eve can kill ya when you're trying to hit your ride to anywhere. The icy air I'm breathing's all that keeps me on my feet. I feel like I've been walking all my life. I call cargo's running by, the man don't even turn his head. Guess he's busy being Santa Claus tonight. The saddest part of all is knowing if I switched with him, I'd leave him stumbling ragged by the road. I'd ride that highway to the arms of my sweet family and forget about the stranger in the cold. And Christmas Eve can kill you when you're trying to hitch a ride to anywhere. As I walk, I'm singing to myself, oh, silent night, hoping I can save those other souls. Oh, God, forgive the man that drives right by the other man. Take pity on the stranger in the car. 'Cause Christmas Eve, to hit your ride to anywhere. Yeah, Christmas Eve can kill you when you're trying to hit your ride to anywhere.
What a horrible song. That is the worst Christmas song I have ever heard in my life. Are you kidding me? Oh, God, Kim, you have actually, I was sitting there. I'm completely depressed now. This is the worst thing. You have broken Christmas for me. Here are the poor son of a bitch is on the side of the road wondering. He's cold and Christmas Eve he's trying to get somewhere because Christmas Eve is going to kill him, and he's just trying, come on, some stranger stop for me, I'm standing on the, oh, good God, Kim, that's horrible. What did you, I'm just blown away by the depth of the, what I love about the song is that it actually shows the side of Christmas that is so solemn and is so gets an opportunity to get into the deep melancholy and the wondering and the, all that. I loved it. I'm so glad you gave us that opportunity to do that.
So, yeah, thank you.
Tell me about it. So tell me.
No. Why, so here's the thing.
Help me to understand. Now here's the thing. You know, I'm neither a musician nor poet. Okay. So you can help to educate me on what that song was about.
So I'm going to educate you. Okay. As best I can.
Yes, ma'am.
Given that I only heard the song for the first time, maybe about a month ago.
Yeah.
But then I went all in on, like, I was obsessed with it when I first heard it because, yeah, I mean, I thought the same thing. Like, it seems pretty dark, right?
But it's so real. That's not the thing. I mean, when we have all this artificiality that says that you have to feel a certain way, you have to be a certain way in order to be able to experience Christmas, mm-hmm. that's just not who we are as human beings. We are full spectrum. Mm-hmm. So the fact that that I guess Phil or Don, I don't know who was the writer in.
Yeah, I wonder who was a writer on this one, actually. And that I would have to look it up and see. But here's what I love about the song, though. I mean, because, like, I looked it up and everything, and there's lots of commentary about it and about this album. It's on an album from 1972 called Stories We Could Tell, and the album itself is pretty dark also. Mm. But here's the thing, though. Like, I don't think this song is that dark. Like, to me, I think that it's about forgiveness. Because, like, it's basically saying, like, you know, God, forgive the man that drives right by the other man. So forgive him as well as, right? And so I feel like the song to me is mm-hmm. about, like, we're all the same. And it's so easy to judge people because maybe they're not doing enough or they're not helping the hitchhiker or whatever, but you don't really know what they're going through either. What I love about the song. Like, I don't think it's dark, really. I think it's about forgiveness. That's what it's about to me.
Thank you for putting that spin on it, because you helped me to you helped me to see things in another way, because something will land for me, and it'll be interesting. What I would love to do is next Christmas, assuming that I'm still around, I would love for you to play that song for me again and let me hear it differently. Do you ever do that where you'll hear something one way one time, and then later on, as you're in a different place, that you'll hear the same song, but it'll be different for you?
Oh God, for sure. And because I associate so much like songs with like place and with time and everything. So yeah, the meanings can definitely change a lot.
Oh wonderful. Well, thank you. Thank you, Kim Ware, for bringing us.
I'm here to introduce, we have another guest who's waiting. We actually have two other guests waiting. So I want to bring one of them up first real quick. I don't know how his voice is going to be.
Yes. Hello.
Well, this one makes sense.
Are you liking
it? No. Oh, it's a pleasure. I'm so glad. I have a feeling that you are the one that has caused all this. I think the chaos is your game. Exactly. I hear the cackle. And so that's what we're doing. But it's so nice to see you. And I love bringing John on just to show his dismay and his complete, bring him on as like from the peanut gallery to be able to say, oh, wow, man, this is awful.
I don't mind being a punching bag for y'all.
No. How did you take that as being a punching bag?
I don't know.
It's a question of you're doing commentary, John, that's all.
I'm trying not to spontaneously combust.
Why? Because there's an audio error? It's
you don't and
how'd you ever get this?
Yeah.
It is.
Yeah.
I know you don't like audio errors, Jonathan. Hello, Dr. Piranha.
A question from the audience.
Yes. Question.
Yes, Dr. Piranha?
Yes.
Yes, I heard you say that.
Nine.
Kim and I both went like this.
I'm trying to understand you, sir.
My favorite part was when you insulted Kim's.
Nothing. You might as well be talking in your native language.
Can you go to the other camera? Dr. Piranha, there is another place in your house where maybe you could go and access that other camera, because
no, my work is finished.
All right.
Have a great show, everybody.
Well, you have a great great time, Dr. Piranha. Thank you. Thank you for coming by and warbling at us.
Doing the Home Alone thing. Okay, bye, Dr. Piranha, but we do have another guest here.
Yes.
Hello.
And she's muted, or now she's not. Hello, Sandy D.
Hello.
Aha.
Am I in trouble?
No, you're not in trouble.
No, God, no.
Like, jelly cake has no, the sound is warbled, so like, now I am upset. But no, I've been waiting to speak to Renee, and I'm so crazy right now. Like, you guys got me so jammed up. I don't know what to do. Kim Ware has me like this. Like, Kim Ware. Kim Ware, I cannot believe how good you are. You are amazing. Like, can we get a... Thank you very much.
I hate that button, by the way.
I concur.
I love
totally.
You so much. You are all amazing. Even when we have technical issues, like you know, you cannot stop this train. You know, it's true. Like Corey Lynn says, you cannot stop this train.
Like Corey Lynn says, you cannot stop this train.
Yeah. I've been waiting for Renee. Okay. Renee, I've been listening to the American music, you know? Mm-hmm. And I found the American singer. I think you might like to enjoy it as well. Her name is Cher. She goes by Cher. And she sings a song called Do You Believe Life After Love? And I want to know if you, my sister, also know this song, because I think it is an amazing song. Because like when love kicks you in the shins, do you believe life after love? Like, is this a good question, no?
I like how Eastern Europe gets American culture like 30 years down the line.
Yes.
That is so true. And yes, I have heard of Cher. I've definitely heard of Cher. And no, I don't believe in life after love. But the good news is that love is always here. So you don't have to believe in life after love. But I'll have to go back to the song lyrics, the very deep song lyrics that Cher has written, and I'll have to pore over the tomes of Cherness to find out if I'm wrong.
I'm going to hang out with Jellycake in the bayou, and I'm going to teach him the song. Do you believe life after love? Because sometimes love kicks you in the shins. You still need to believe in something, right?
That's right. Drita, has love kicked you in the shins? Drita, I feel like there might be some personal enemies.
Many times, but you know, we always can make strawberry cake, and sometimes that is the comfort food for me and my culture. We have comfort food, and we make strawberry cake for the family, and this works, you know. And we also have 3-day massage. We have 3-day massage. I can give you the recipe for it. It's a 3-day massage in Albania, and this is real thing. Like, I know you're my sister, but you have culture. I have culture. Together, we can. But listen, I got to tell you about the new song from Cher, because
I do feel like the 3-day massage.
I'm like amazed by this song.
I feel like that 3-day massage by day 3, they're investigating areas that no one else has investigated.
I think Jonathan Phipps needs 3-day Albanian massage, because let me tell you, this thing works. It starts with the grandma. You have to have the grandma has to do it. Okay, so the grandma.
If I did the 3-day massage, I would be found over 4 different states. I feel like.
Oh my gosh, we have got the. I just want to say this is this comment right here. I don't know who's saying it, but Kim Ware is the John Cena of relaxing songwriting, and I just think that's beautiful.
$5 says it's Troy Moore.
Oh. Okay, Drita, would you like to sing a song for us?
I have song. I love Irina. I was wondering if Irina was available today, because I miss her so much. She is like my sister from another mister. And
I'll go. And
she
I'll
has.
Go see.
She has I'll a song. There's a song I have been learning, and it goes like. I might need my microphone. I don't know. I still want to talk about my 3-day massage. I still have to tell Jonathan Phipps about 3-day massage, because I think he.
No, you don't. You're good. You're good. I'm good. You're good.
Has anyone here ever had a 3-day massage? Just ask anyone in the audience. Anyone?
It's very simple. Okay, I will give you a recipe, Dennis. I will give you a recipe.
Yes.
Because this is very good. Like, you have to have grandma. Grandma lives in the house with you, okay? But first you have grandma, and grandma does the 3-day massage to everyone in the family, because grandma has so much love to give, okay? The first day, she steps on your back, and she breaks up the muscles with her feet on your back. You lay on the floor, and she steps on your muscles. She breaks up the muscles the first day, okay? Then you relax, and you sleep, and you eat strawberry cake. The second day.
Is the second day when grandpa comes?
No, grandpa, he does not. Grandpa, you know, I'll tell you, that's a different. Okay, second day, she.
Are we sure this is Albania and not West Virginia?
No, this is Albanian culture. Okay, second day, grandma massages the muscles, and you're like in heaven, okay? Then, third day, and you cannot do the 3-day massage. You cannot do any exercises, anything. You cannot lift. You cannot pull, push, anything extraneous. You have to relax in the 3 days. You cannot do anything heavy. You cannot overexert your body in those 3 days. You have to relax the whole 3 days, okay? Second day, she gives them good massage, and you feel like heaven. It's like heaven. Third day, she puts the muscles back in place. And this is all with her grandma's feet, okay? And this is family tradition, you know? So I just want to share the family traditions with all of you that may not know the family traditions, because it's very important. 3D massage make your life so much better. Like, you don't know. You don't
sign me up. That's
Kim
all.
Kim looks absolutely horrified.
and again, Dennis Tardan is like
stone face.
Doesn't stone bother face. Him in the least.
Dennis okay. is like, that's just fine.
Dennis is just, the cat's on fire and it's fine. All right.
It's fine.
And look who's here. Here's...
You're finally back.
Hello, sir.
Hello, everyone. Happy holidays. Oh,
hi. Hello. Hello, Rory. Welcome back to the show. I'm so glad we've been trying to keep the wheels on while you were gone. But
yeah, how did everything
I don't,
go?
I'm not as well as you would like. I'm glad that you got here from work, but I'm not sure that it's gone. that we've had some audio issues with some of our guests who were trying to wish you a Merry Christmas and to make sure that we could let them go. So it didn't work very well, but I'm so glad you've come back to take over the helm.
I'll look over at it in post.
Good.
We'll see what happened after the fact.
So take it away, Rory.
Oh, well, first off, I want to ask everybody what they plan to do for Christmas. And it's so good to see everybody. It's good to see Jonathan and Renee. The last few shows of mine, they've been kind of disappearing behind the scenes. And, you know, I was watching some of the older shows where we first started out, and it was like you guys are doing here. You know, everybody was on screen, and we had everybody's personality, and it was nice. You know, it was the team, and I hope we go back to that next year. You know, you guys being there and giving your commentary as well, and again, it was a better feel.
Mm-hmm. It is wonderful. I want to congratulate you, Rory, on doing a season. How many shows has it been?
I think we've done about 36 or 37 shows. This might be 37. Wow.
That is a huge number, Rory. I mean, to be able to do that is so congratulations
thank you.
For doing the due diligence.
Thank you, sir.
And oh, by the way, I want as you acknowledge, as all of us will acknowledge, that the reason why you were able to do that many shows is because of the work of Renee Jaworski, who has done all the directing, who has done the work as she's done.
Why am I here? Wait,
yes, the switching, the directing, and the producing.
Exactly, and producing and putting up the videos and doing all
Pretty
the work.
Much.
And not only that, but doing the coordination. So that's the reason
why. So lovely
why.
To have her. I'm
yeah,
so lucky.
I mean, we are really lucky that she is that as the chief operating officer of the network. And I want everyone to understand that's why this runs. And so that's why we treat her well. We talk to her well. We talk to her. We make sure that we do not treat her like a secretary, that we make sure that she is treated as the executive that
Even
she
though
is,
I'm wearing
right?
A peacock
everybody.
Feather. Even well, though I'm yeah. wearing a peacock feather.
But anyway, yes. This is after. But just make sure that we're respecting her work.
Thank you. Definitely. Thank you so much. I appreciate that. And I am offering 3-day massages in the.
Oh, Jesus. Here we go.
So that's another thing that I can do as COO. I feel like.
Wow.
Just a free one. It's on the house.
It's been a while since I had a 3-day massage. I had one in China.
Helicopters are on their way.
Did you really have a 3-day? Wait. He just said something.
It involved a grandmother, though, which was kind of weird.
Where was it?
You were listening the whole time. Oh, my gosh. That is
no.
Hilarious.
I just came in.
Oh, that's right. Oh, he said he did. It involved a grandmother. Did you know,
Where,
Tito, that the Chinese version of 3-day massage is apparently very similar to the Albanian?
Wow.
And there's another thing called ants climbing up a tree, but I don't want to go into that.
We'll just let the
nightmare
mind wander
fuel.
On that one.
Okay. Yes. I feel like Kim Ware has another song up her sleeve. Yes.
I would love to hear a Kim Ware song.
Oh, me too.
I'm so excited. She was going to sing some
But if
Christmas
you're going to if
tonight.
You're going to depress me, if you're going to depress me even more,
oh,
I you know, so I could we have something just or at least
depress
me. At least prepare me to be able to say Dennis, do not, you know, be very careful with this Christmas song, because this is going to go into some dark places, and then I'm prepared, and then
I'm
at
sorry.
Least I
dark
know,
places.
Right? Because so far you have broken Christmas for me. So bring me back.
Oh God,
Rory missed the first one.
Oh my God, what did I miss?
I'm so sorry, Dennis. But like, I really want to play my. This is my favorite, like, seasonal. It's not really Christmas, it's a seasonal song.
I love that.
But it's kind of melancholy too. That's my thing, though.
I don't mind melancholy at all, as long as I'm prepared.
You're prepared.
It's like, have you ever, you know, somebody says, "Oh, you need to taste this. This is a great," and you know, and it ends up being something that's different from what you're prepared for.
That's the worst, right? Yes.
That's what I'm saying. So that was all. I just wasn't prepared. I was all. Oh, good Christmas, and how are we move here? And then suddenly it's. I'm dead in Christmas and everything is dark and I'm sitting by the side of the road as everybody is driving by me and I'm freezing my ass off and God forgive them because I want to be able to do it. And I'm going, oh my God, help me.
Y'all are on a new level tonight and I love it.
Anyway, so bring me back. Kim, you can do it. You have resurrected me. You have brought my spirit back over and over and over.
I think Rory has something to say.
Please do it.
I don't know if I can bring you all the way back. But
yes, you can. You have done it. You have done it time and time again.
We're going to hold you responsible. No pressure, Kim, but you must now.
You have to do it. Bring Dennis back. Bring Dennis back.
Press the button.
Press the button.
I want every man to know that every woman has a button. Men just don't know
that. Oh my God, Renee. You're opening up a lot of cans of worms.
I didn't do it, Kim. I promise you. I swear. I was just looking to be resurrected. I wasn't doing that. Please bring me back.
Okay. We'll see.
Oh, everybody. Okay.
It's the feather.
Everyone threw up a heart. A long December, and there's reason to believe maybe this year will be better than the last. I can't remember the last thing that you said as you were leaving. Now the days go by so fast, and it's one more day up in the canyon, and it's one more night in Hollywood. If you think that I could be forgiven, I wish you would. Na 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 na. Smell of hospitals in winter, and the feeling that it's all a lot of oysters, no pearls. All at once you look across a crowded room to see the way that light attaches to a girl. And it's one more day up in the canyon. One more night in Hollywood. You think you might come to California? I think you should. Na 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 na. Sometime after 2 a.m. and talked a little while about the year. I guess the winter makes you laugh a little slower, makes you talk a little lower about the things you could not show her. And it's been a long December, and there's reason to believe maybe this year will be better than the last. Can't remember all the times I tried to tell myself to hold on to these moments as they pass. And It's one more day up in the canyon, and it's one more night in Hollywood. It's been so long since I've seen the ocean. I guess I should. Na 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 na.
See, you brought me back. You brought me back. Wow. See? Oh, thank you.
It.
What a lovely, what a lovely, lovely ballad. And it's just, it's, thank you.
Thank you. Yeah, that's, I've been getting Counting Crows recently. And that's, wow. I swear, that's my favorite, like, seasonal-ish
song. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it's good stuff.
Yep,
it is. I love that, and I could imagine, you know, if we had different software in on the planet, where we would be able to all vibe together and sing along at the final chorus, you know. But Sandy and I were sort of doing that in our own muted way. I wanted Jonathan has an announcement about Tardan Media on New Year's Eve.
Oh yes,
yes.
There's quite a few. Hopping in. So what we are doing on New Year's Eve is we are doing a New Year's Eve festival. NTMN. Kim above me will be a part of it. That lady to my right, or to my left, your right, is being a part of it. Sandy D and Grand. The lady up in the upper right-hand corner up there is participating.
Diane
Whether
Paul
she looks
is participating,
yes.
Lars Nagel.
Yes.
Wonderful.
Kim is going to be there. Sandy's there. Renee is there, though she may not look like 1966 then. Much to our chagrin.
I resent that. It's 1924.
Yeah, she's doing the flapper thing.
Yes, she is doing a flapper.
28.
So,
28, yes. Thank you.
But yeah,
Prohibition.
Performances are running from noon on New Year's Eve to 8 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time, Eastern Standard Time. And then from 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time up to midnight, we are doing live editions of all of our shows. And it will start at 8 p.m. to 9 p.m. with this very show. It's casual. Then it will go 9 to 10 p.m. with Powered by Women, Diane Marie's show. And then from 10 to 11 Eastern Time, it will be my show, which is One Hit Wonderful, which will be coming back in the new year. And then 11 p.m. to midnight, a special countdown edition of the R&D Cafe live from the corner of Conversation Street and Anecdote Avenue. It's going to be a wonderful go of it,
awesome.
And I cannot wait to see y'all perform.
Conversation Street and Anecdote Avenue.
Yep,
that needs
R&D
to be a new
Cafe.
Show. That needs to be a show name. I love that.
No, I'm saying that's where the R&D Cafe is, at the corner of Conversation
that's
Street
so cool.
and Anecdote Avenue.
Well, now Jonathan was just telling, before we went live, I heard Jonathan telling Kim about the origin story of TMN, which kind of was one of the reasons why Jonathan wanted to, he coordinated all of that, by the way. This is Jonathan Phipps. He coordinated absolutely all of that. I'm hearing about this kind of like when you guys are. It was important to him to do an annual marker because, yes, this is the story that will live on in legend, which is that Dennis and I had not yet known how to go live. We didn't know how to do that. We were doing taped programs. And on New Year's Eve or whenever of last year, we were arguing about something. And then he said, well, we'll just do it. Why don't we do it live? And
Shocker,
I dared him.
I know,
said, yeah, well, you do it live. And then he said, fine. And then he hung up on me. And then I get a text. How do we go live? And then we figured it out. And this was just on Facebook Messenger. We didn't have the studio or anything.
Gosh.
We did. And suddenly, and that was the first live transmission, mm-hmm. which now has become Tardan Media Network, and the fans latched on. We had Dennis for Famous. We did a conversation with live. We did Tardan Tonight, and that's when Rory came aboard and Jonathan came aboard, and all of this happened, synthesizing with KMH, of course, and SDF. And it just, and Sandy and everybody just came on board, and it became a whole zeitgeist. Mm-hmm. And it all came from that one day. And hopefully we have that recorded somewhere, but it's, the rest is history.
I think you do. Ray, I think it is. Ray, if it's okay with you, can I tell the story of how I came to join this network? Only if it's okay with you.
What? Ask Dennis. I don't know.
Dennis, if it's all right with you.
Certainly, this is Rory's show. So okay, we could.
Yeah, I would fine. Really like it.
I would really prefer if Rory ran the show. It's his show, so let's make sure that he's included.
Here
I'm trying to be respectful to all who are shown here.
And
Rory just said he wanted all of us here.
Rory came on board.
Rory, I want you to tell your story about how you joined this deal as well. So
I can.
Go for it. If you want to go first, go for it.
You go first.
Okay. If you want to. So we were, it was, I believe it was, correct me if I'm wrong, Renee and Dennis, if it was the premiere of Tardan Tonight. Am I correct on that?
Are you talking Tardan about the Tom
Tardan Tonight,
Cheshire?
Not quite.
Yes. Tardan not Tonight, quite. Not quite. Okay, so. Yes, so they were going to have the legendary Tom Cheshire, and I'll keep this as short as I can. Tom came on. They wanted Tom on the show, and they got him on, and he was just having just bukus of sound issues, about like how Dragon Elvis and the rest had going on earlier. But CJ Peters, being the badass he is, stepped into the slot. And it was a fantastic show. I've got to say, it was amazing. And I messaged Renee. I think I messaged Renee afterwards saying, man, you did really good. Like, you kept cool under fire. And she came to me fully in tears over how everything
Well,
wound
I was
up.
Texting and, you and I said I was upset. I don't know that
you,
I was.
No, you were past upset. She was saying stuff like, oh, I'm going to get out of this. I'm going to find Dennis a producer. I'm going to sell all my stuff, move into the woods in Canada.
Literally none of that happened, but that did not happen, but okay.
Okay, anyways. The Canada part didn't happen. The Canada part didn't happen, but everything else did.
I'm going to ride a Canada goose all the way up to Canada, and then there's going to be a leprechaun, and I'm going to sell my golden coins.
You wanted to go to Canada, do you?
So I said to Renee, I was just not expecting anything at all to come from it. I said, you know, if you need help, I don't know anything about this really. I've never really had a hand in any of this, but if you want me to come on, I'll be more than willing to learn. And that was back in, what was it, mid-February?
Well, we had a meeting. It was me, you, and Dennis. Mm-hmm. Dennis that and was... I sat down with you, and we had a meeting, and you pitched some ideas to us.
Yes, and then within 2 months, I was hosting a show on this network, which was, and still is, One Hit Wonderful. I'm looking forward to getting back to that, and I'm looking forward to being a bigger part of this network.
Yeah, and then Rory came on, and that's when It's Casual came, was right after that.
So Rory, tell us your story.
I had a friend from my high school days named John Bird, who had been watching some stuff from Tardan Media.
I love John Bird.
He's quite a character himself. Mm-hmm. And he told me, you're going to love this girl, Renee. She does character. She's very funny. She's a lot of fun. And he said, you should connect with her because I can see you two doing some comedy together. And I said, really? And I contacted Renee and I told her that, you know, I'd done stand-up comedy for a while. I did a lot of voices, did a lot of characters, and she jumped on that. She was just, we gotta get you to meet Dennis Tardan. And I watched an episode of Tardan Tonight, Not Quite, and I was like, wow, this is really cool. I would love to be a part of this. I would love to maybe do some bits on the show, you know, some comedy bits and things. And that's how it all got started. And eventually I got the idea to ask them, would it be okay if I did a show myself called It's Casual? Or I actually think that might have been Renee's idea, actually. Mm-hmm. Okay. And I said, well, I used to do a show called It's Casual on public access cable in Tampa. You know, we could probably call it that. I don't think my producer, who's a good friend of mine, would mind us calling it It's Casual. And we talked to Dennis, and he's like, yeah, I would love to see that. So that's how it all got started.
Congratulations. Wow. Congratulations to both of you. Thank you for the hard work and what y'all
Yeah, thank you all for what you do with these shows. And, you know, I mean, it's a lot of fun doing One Hit Wonderful. I was very happy to find a place to do The Judge, which was a character I created in China in open mic night. And I would critique the comedy shows, the sets.
Yes. I've had a few people
wonder. There's going to be nowhere I can do this guy again ever. And boom, we decided to do him on One Hit Wonderful.
I've had a few people ask where The Judge is, and The Judge will be back January 6th with all the rest of us.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Sooner and expected, I do want to give a shout out to Kim Ware, of course, Andy Gish, Monica Arrington.
Yes.
With Kimono My House, because
that's the only way we happened.
Right. Kimono My House is actually like the godmother, right, of this whole thing, because we, you know, they were already incorporated and doing their thing, and Lars Nagel went and yanked me out of the gutter and cleaned me up, dried me off, blow dried me, whatever.
Yep.
And give me a 3-day massage.
Oh, Jesus. Here we go. Here we go.
Okay, I'm gonna step away from Renee here, because I don't want to be anywhere near when this thing blows up.
I can't even breathe. This is so funny. Look at Drita.
Drita finds this funny.
Is gonna live in infamy, okay? And the button. And I just love that there's a button and a 3-day massage. Drita, you have brought so much to this episode. It will be legendary because of you. But yeah, so it's Kimono My House, of course. And that's how we started integrating with them. And then, of course, Socially Distant Fest with Jake Allen and Bethy Allen. It's just a whole, there's sister networks and all that. And we keep sharpening each other and challenging each other and advancing the ball down the field. So
bringing happiness and love to the world.
Yeah, absolutely. One broadcast at a time. And children, I want to thank you for letting the old man be on here for the evening, for this late time. And
the doggy.
And the dog. The dog is obviously welcoming me too. And I want to thank y'all. Thank you for the work that you've done, Rory. Congratulations on your show and all of them, and the work that you've done, John, and continuing to work. And Renee, of course, for making all the trains run on time.
I am Mussolini.
Ingrid and all there, and the amazing Kim Ware. Thank you for being such a good sport with me and allowing me to do comedy with you. That was such a gracious thing for you to allow me to do that and to play with you.
Thank you, Dennis.
And shout out to, we are preparing some kind of a Christmas thing. So we don't have the exact details, but sometime this week, Tardan Media is going to have a Christmas thing. I don't know what to call it. Christmas thing.
Sure.
It's called a Christmas thing.
A Christmas get together,
or something like that. So everybody, be on
Christmas massage.
A Christmas 3-day massage.
Exactly.
Dennis, you've made it this far. Just stand for 90 seconds. Don't be the first one out. Just stay. We're leaving. Let's do it.
Now he's going to give you the silent treatment, Renee.
I have a story I want to tell.
Look at it. I love that. No, I already ran the credits. Yes. Thank you. Oh, and Bob Ross just walked in. Bob, you're late. Bob, you come lately. We're wrapping now, Bob. We're wrapping.
Oh.
Bob, I'm going to have to watch most of it in post as well.
What'd you say,
one more time for the button to end.
I said I'm going to have to watch most of the post as well.
Oh, okay. All right. Press the button, Sandy, and then we will all say good night.
Love you guys.
Happy holidays.
Love you too.
Sandy,
happy holidays, everybody.
Bye.